Artem Taranenko versus Mindaugas Tarasaitis. Both Artem and Mindaugas are coming from a loss in East versus West.
12 and 13.
And will come at a win in 14 very hard. It would be a tedious task for Artem to generate enough pressure to break the sturdy hold of Mindaugas, but I think Artem shall claim his first win in this one. Raymond Lipins versus Ryan Belinger. Like all of us, Coach Ray is also trying to get some information about Ryan Belinger. Other than being a strong hook player, Belinger is a part of the Carolina Chaos arm wrestling team coached by Chad Silver. Coach Ray, however, has a balanced record in East versus West so far, losing 6 to Doug and winning 4 against another Ryan. I give this one to Raymond's until Belinger turns out to be a complete freak. Jonathan Breda versus Emeric Pradeen. Breda's first left-hand encounter in East versus West 2 against Zurab Tabvaridze ended in a loss. The American is returning to the stage again with better technique and bigger aspirations. Emeric, on the other hand, have something special planned for Jonathan. The experience and technicality of the French shall stop the US force, and Pradeen will win this one. Craig Tullier versus Tom Holland. When we talk about sheer brute force in arm wrestling, Craig's name is surely in the top 5 freakishly strong arms in the sport. Tom Holland's static strength shall not be enough to encounter the speed and ferocity of Tullier, and I give this one to Craig. Doug Ehrlich versus Hunter Knobs. The pre-match banter between Hunter and Doug is a treat for the fans. The hype is real, the hate is heated, and the confidence is over the top. After teaching Coach Ray a lesson or two in East versus West 6, and then being coached by Daniel Prokopchik in 7, Doug is coming with experience and size, whereas Hunter will pounce on his debut prey. Doug takes this one after a war of attrition. Elizabeth Ray Mocek versus Alexandra Ozerova. Elizabeth lost to Carolina Patterson in her debut match in East versus West 8. While Alexandra is eyeing an explosive debut for herself in this 14th edition. Though size of Elizabeth gives a different perspective, I think the speed and technicality of Ozerova shall prevail in this banger of a match. Justin Bishop versus Yanis Amolins. The Bama Bulls' run in East versus West has not been a successful one so far. He lost both his matches to Mindaugas and Tom Rosetz and is itching for a win this time. While the Jedi Yanis is ready for a battle, the technicality and versatility favors Amolins, and I think Justin will be stopped a third time over. Reds Sadrakyan versus Paul Talbot. When there is a talk about compact, heavy-duty, sturdy and strong inside game, there are a very few in the lightweight category who can budge Red's left from center, and Paul is surely one of them. Still, it is quite hard for me to imagine Paul's top role opening up Sadrakyan's rock-solid inside defense. I give this one to Red's Sadrakyan. Paul Lynn versus Rustam Babayev. The legend of Babayev is coming back to East versus West after giving hell of a war to Irakli Zirakashvili in the 10th edition. In the meantime, the legend of the White Oak is rising slowly in the arm wrestling arenas around the world. Their first encounter resulted in a bicep injury to Rustam, who was 2 pins ahead of Paul. This time, Paul Lynn is a different beast altogether. Rustam needs to bring his A-game to the table, or else this one is going to be in Paul's kitty as well. Matt Mask versus Lars Rohrbacken. After having his share of wins and losses in King of the Table, Lars is finally arriving to the stage of East versus West in a quest of taming the wild horse. This one is going to be a battle between press and top role. Matt will raise hell on the table, but it shall be a 3-2 win for the strong man from Norway. Travis Bagent versus Corey West. Travis Bagent is no fool to have accepted this match with Gorilla after getting his talkative ass handed to him by Sergey Kalinichenko. Either he is bluffing again about his shape, or this time he'll walk the talks. Corey is ready 100%, but Travis is under scanner for this one too. I'm gonna place my bets one more time on the Beast, and then I'll rest my case until he comes really prepared. Michael Todd versus Kamil Yablonsky. Michael Todd 3.0 is a saga of unrealistic goals and superficial milestones. So far, Michael is successful in his quest of becoming the world champion one last time. But this time, the monster has to ride the Golden Dragon. Kamil Yablonsky will be the toughest test for Todd, and I think this match will be a speed breaker in Michael's journey. Yablonsky presses his way towards victory in this one. Todd Hutchings versus Jochen Prudnik. The way Prudnik toyed with Toddzilla in East versus West 4 was incredible. It was almost a godlike performance from Prudnik against someone so strong and efficient like Hutchings. After his bout with Devin, something has changed quite drastically in Prudnik though. His antics are overshadowing his arm wrestling prowess for quite some time. Still, my wits somehow tend to give this one again to Prudnik. Sorry, Uncle Todd. Dave Chaffee versus Frank Lamparelli. Dave is in a war of all the possible maneuvers in the arm wrestling book on 10th of August. Frank stepped in toe-to-toe with Michael Todd in his last match, and he is head over heels to turn that lost cause into a winning bonanza. Easy money Dave shall not give in to the power of this Italian maverick and comes out victorious in this one. Jerry Cadoret versus Alex Corveja. Jerry's second coming after a loss to Hermes Gasparini is long overdue now. While Big Daddy is preparing for his comeback silently in his dungeon, Alex is on a rampage, having back-to-back impressive bouts with quality opposition. Jerry's style is a nightmare for everyone in the arm wrestling community, but Corveja has developed his own flop wrist press as well. Alex Corveja shall win this one after a bloody war and a table full of sweat. John Brzenk versus Leonidas Arkona. Let's cherish one more time the sight we all love to behold and admire. John is back on the table, and this time his opponent is a bodybuilder come arm wrestler. With an absurd bicep strength and a desire to achieve the incredible feat of pulling and beating the goat. John Brzezinski's pronator, hand strength and table IQ are going to clinch this one from the jaws of Arkona. As the word goes, you don't bet against the goat. If you like my content and love arm wrestling, then like, share and subscribe. Keep healthy, keep hustling. This is Nitin Vats signing off.